Hello friends, today I am going to discuss about classification of chromatographic techniques. So here I have classified chromatographic techniques into four categories. First one is according to the principle, second one is according to the polarity of the phases, third one is according to the mobile phase, and the fourth one is according to the geometry. Now I am writing sub parts of this classification. So according to principle, first one is adsorption, second one is partition, third one is ion exchange, fourth one is size exclusion, and the last one is affinity. Now coming to the second one, which is according to the polarity of the phases. According to the polarity of the phases, chromatography is classified into two categories. First one is normal phase and second one is reversed phase. Now coming to the third one, which is according to the mobile phase. According to the mobile phase, chromatography is categorized into three categories. First one is liquid chromatography, second one is gas chromatography, and third one is supercritical fluid chromatography. Now again, liquid chromatography is categorized into two categories, which is liquid-liquid chromatography and liquid-solid chromatography. Now again, gas chromatography is divided into two categories. First one is GSC and second one is GLC. Now coming to the fourth category, which is according to the geometry. According to the geometry, chromatographic technique is divided into two categories. First one is planar chromatography and second one is column chromatography. Again, these planar and column chromatographies are classified into various categories or subcategories, which are listed here. So this is the overview about classification of chromatographic techniques. Now coming to the first one, which is according to the principle. as I have already discussed in detail about principles of chromatography in my previous video. So first one is adsorption. So it is based on adsorption phenomena. In adsorption chromatography, stationary phase is solid and mobile phase is either gas or liquid. Now coming to the second one, which is partition chromatography. According to the partition chromatography, stationary phase will always be liquid and mobile phase will be liquid or it may be gas. Now coming to the third one, ion exchange chromatography. According to this chromatography, separation takes place due to exchange of ions, means ion exchanger regions are there. As I have already discussed the details in my previous video, you can watch my previous video about principle of chromatography for details. Now coming to the next one, which is size exclusion chromatography. According to this chromatography, we are selecting such a sample where molecular weight difference should be there between compounds in any mixture, because separation takes place due to difference in the molecular weight in size exclusion chromatography. And in this chromatography, we are using various types of gels as a stationary phase. It may be soft gel, it may be semi-rigid gel, or it may be rigid gel. Okay. Now coming to the next one, which is affinity chromatography. According to this chromatography, we can separate some specific compound. For example, antisense antibody, carbohydrate lectins, etc. Now coming to the next category, which is according to the polarity of the phases. According to the polarity of the phases, chromatographic technique is divided into two categories. First one is normal phase and second one is reverse phase. In normal phase chromatography, stationary phase will always be polar, and in reverse phase, stationary phase will always be non-polar. So in normal phase chromatography, stationary phase is polar, then mobile phase will be non-polar. In normal phase chromatography, stationary phase is non-polar, then mobile phase will be polar. So this is the basic difference between both these chromatography. So here I am giving one example of TLC. In TLC, we are taking silica gel as a stationary phase. As you know, due to presence of OH group in surface of silica gel, silica gel acts as a polar stationary phase. So we will use non-polar mobile phase in TLC. Now coming to the next one, which is reverse phase chromatography. What is reverse phase chromatography? In reverse phase chromatography, we are using non-polar stationary phase. Example is RPHPLC. RPHPLC means reverse phase high performance liquid chromatography. In this chromatography, we are using C18 column. C18 column contains ODS silica gel, means silica gel will be modified, and there will be attachment of hydrocarbon, which is octadecyl silane, and due to presence of this octadecyl silane, our silica gel will become non-polar. So in RPHPLC, stationary phase will be non-polar, and so we will use mobile phase, which will be polar in nature. And what is the benefit of this reverse phase chromatography? We are using polar mobile phase that will be easily available, and that will be cheaper as compared to non-polar mobile phase. So overall cost will be decreased. Now coming to the next one, which is according to the mobile phase. According to the mobile phase, we have classified the chromatographic techniques into three categories. First one is liquid chromatography, means here liquid mobile phase will be there. Second one is gas chromatography, so here gas will act as a mobile phase. And third one is supercritical fluid chromatography. It is also known as SFC. Now coming to the first one, which is liquid chromatography. What is liquid chromatography? In liquid chromatography, we are using liquid mobile phase. So liquid chromatography is again divided into two categories. First one is liquid chromatography, means liquid mobile phase and liquid stationary phase. Second one is liquid solid chromatography, means liquid mobile phase and solid stationary phase. As you know, due to presence of liquid chromatography, principle will be partition chromatography, because here liquid is present. So according to the liquid chromatography, first one is taper chromatography and second one is droplet counter current chromatography, which is also known as DCCC. So what happens in paper chromatography? So in paper chromatography, we are using paper as a stationary phase, and paper is made up of alpha cellulose, and in alpha cellulose 6% moisture is there in the surface of the paper, and that moisture acts as an active stationary phase. So ultimately in the paper liquid is present in the form of moisture, and that moisture acts as an active stationary phase or active surface. So ultimately stationary phase is liquid and mobile phase is again liquid, and separation takes place due to partition coefficient in paper chromatography. Now coming to the DCCC, in DCCC we are using two types of liquids. One will be high density liquid and second one is low density liquid. If we are using high density liquid as a stationary phase, then a mobile phase will be low density liquid. If we are using low density stationary phase, then mobile phase will be high density stationary phase. And separation takes place due to partition coefficient. I will discuss the details of DCCC in separate portion of DCCC. Now coming to the liquid solid chromatography. Most of the chromatography techniques falls under this category, which is liquid solid chromatography. It means liquid mobile phase and solid stationary phase. So in this category, first one is column chromatography. What is column chromatography? Column is a hollow tube under which we have to fill stationary phase, and through the stationary phase our mobile phase will run, and when mobile phase will run, sample will be there, and the sample will also run through the column due to affinity with either mobile phase or stationary phase, and separation takes place. Now coming to the next one, which is TLC. In TLC we are using solid stationary phase, and again mobile phase will be liquid. Full name of TLC is thin layer chromatography. Now coming to the next one, which is HPTLC. In HPTLC same thing is happened. It is advanced version of TLC, and the full name of HPTLC is high performance thin layer chromatography. What is difference between TLC and HPTLC? There is difference between the particle size of the stationary phase. In TLC, average particle size of stationary phase is approximate 15 micrometer, but in HPTLC it is 7 micrometer. So separation will be better because surface area is better in HPTLC. Now coming to the flash chromatography. What is flash chromatography? It is advanced version of column chromatography. In flash chromatography, generally plastic columns are used. And in column chromatography, separation takes place, or mobile phase will run due to gravitational force. But in flash chromatography, we are putting some pressure by using nitrogen gas or by using air up to 15 psi pressure. And the next one is HPLC. What is HPLC? That is high performance liquid chromatography. In HPLC, we are using high pressure, which is 1000 to 4000 psi. And the particle size of the stationary phase will be very low, so separation will be better, and it is a type of column chromatography. Now coming to the next one, in which ion exchanger resins are present in the solid matrix of stationary phase, and separation takes place due to ion exchange. Here separation of proteins or amino acids can be done by ion exchange chromatography. Now coming to the next one, which is size exclusion chromatography. As I have already discussed here, separation takes place due to molecular weight, difference in the molecular weight. Here in size exclusion chromatography, gels are used as a stationary phase, which is solid, and gels means it may be soft gels or it may be rigid or semi-rigid gels, that will be stationary phase, and mobile phase will be liquid. And the next one is UPLC. UPLC is advanced version of HPLC. In UPLC we can put more pressure, which is up to 15,000 psi. So separation will be very fast as compared to HPLC. Now coming to the next one, which is affinity chromatography. As I have already discussed here about affinity chromatography, it is highly specific, like separation of antigen antibody, carbohydrate lectins, etc. So here also in affinity chromatography we are using solid stationary phase, and mobile phase will be liquid. Now coming to the next category, which is gas chromatography. Again, gas chromatography is divided into two categories. First one is GLC, means gas solid chromatography. Gas will be mobile phase and the solid will be stationary phase. And the next one is GLC. Here gas will be mobile phase and the liquid will be stationary phase. So here if stationary phase is solid, then it will be based on adsorption chromatography, and here liquid phase is stationary phase, and liquid and gas is there. So separation takes place due to partition coefficient. So these are the two types of gas chromatography. I will discuss the detail in the separate portion of gas chromatography. So now coming to the supercritical fluid chromatography. In supercritical fluid chromatography, we are using liquid carbon dioxide as a mobile phase. So here pump will be cooled and carbon dioxide will be cooled to convert into the liquid form, and the rest will be just like HPLC, means high performance liquid chromatography. Now coming to the next part, which is according to the geometry. According to the geometry, our chromatographic technique is divided into two categories. First one is planar chromatography, means it will run in the plane like paper chromatography, or in any plate like thin layer chromatography and HPTLC, or it will be column chromatography. In column chromatography, always hollow tube will be there, and in hollow tube there will be stationary phase, and mobile phase will run through the stationary phase. Stationary phase will be static and mobile phase will be dynamic. All these category in planar chromatography, paper chromatography, TLC and HPTLC is there, and in column chromatography, rest all chromatography will come under this category, and I have individually discussed all chromatography here also. Okay, so this is the overview about classification of chromatographic techniques. Thank you.